Former Budget Undersecretary Lloyd Christopher Lau earns the ire of senators for saying hearings on the formula issue are hostile. Lau issued that remark as the Senate panel questioned why he dropped his bid for the overall deputy ombudsman post. Lau said he backed out due to the comments of several politicians, but he refused to answer Senator Richard Gordon's order to specify officials' names.
Forcing me to mention names, which I don't want to do, because I believe people's names who are not part of me should remain private. If they want to air their side and say that they're the ones who said it, let them be. But kung ako, sabihin mo, hindi, si ganito, si ganyan, I'm not that kind of person. Kaya nga nag-withdraw din ako sa application kasi magulo eh.
I believe the situation in Senate investigation is hostile.
The Arnold case, wherein the Senate held a resource person in contempt.
Mr. Chairman, clearly remember former Yusek Lau saying, confirming that yes, he may have failed to exercise due diligence.
Inamin niya ano po, na hindi siya malasakit na magtanong kung ano yung binibigyan niya ng kontrata. Senator DeLong, you wanted to say something, sir?
Parang nagiging weird yung pakiramdam ko, yung resource person na ayaw sumagot ng tanong, siya naman ang nagtatanong sa chairman. Ang weird talaga.
Senators rejecting Lau's comment, he's being treated unfairly.
The Senate will be respectful of resource persons and their rights. But the Senate cannot simply accept that because he refuses to answer the question, that we should respect it.
Yung itong 18th Congress na mga senador, napakababait. Yung mga kamoy, pinuputol yung sagot, yung mga whatever, ganyan. Wala, mild na mild yan.
Formerly Pharmaceuticals Director Lincoln Ong, now detained at the Senate as ordered by the Blue Ribbon Committee. Ong was cited in contempt for failing to submit several financial documents needed for the ongoing probe into the government's pandemic spending. He has also given contradicting statements in previous hearings. Aside from Ong, the Senate also threatened to sanction another formerly official, Auditor Iluminada Sebial, for being evasive.
You are changing your answer after being coached by somebody. Be careful, huh? Because you're under oath.
Sir, I have no documents in my possession because the documents are all in the formally.
I will recommend to the committee that we file a complaint against you in the Professional Regulatory Commission for inexcusable negligence in the performance of your duties. So I would strongly advise you that you submit all the documents that I am requesting.
Formerly Corporate Secretary and Treasurer Buhit Dargani also put on the hot seat. He was questioned about his ties to Presidential Economic Advisor Michael Yang, who is also being linked to the controversial multi-billion deal.
Have you ever worked for the government under Presidential Economic Advisor Yang Hongming or Michael Yang?
No, Your Honor. I've never worked for the government.
Nung LinkedIn page nyo, Mr. Dargani. Ayan po, Special Assistant at Office of the Presidential Economic Advisor. Galing talaga pag may network.
Because I'm not a Chinese and I don't really communicate with their bosses, with Mr. Yang, Mr. Ong advised me that I cannot work in that said office. I assumed that I was working there, but apparently I was not, so I took that down eventually.
The Philippine Red Cross stands by the accuracy of its COVID-19 RT-PCR tests. That's after President Rodrigo Duterte and some congressmen criticized it for yielding false positives. In a statement, the Red Cross confirmed it had to conduct a manual retest after 45 out of the 48 samples tested at its laboratory in the Subic Bay Freeport Zone came out positive. But it says the second round of testing yielded the exact same outcome. PRC also admits the possibility of false positive results, adding no test is 100% accurate. PRC Chairman Senator Richard Gordon also hit back at critics, underscoring the Red Cross's contributions during the pandemic.
Bakit kailangan nyo ang Red Cross, eh, naandun kayong lahat, isang damakbak kayong pumila doon sa Red Cross at sinabi nyo, oh, this is a game changer. Secretary Duque, sasagutin nyo ako, hindi ba pa totoo na ngayon ang Red Cross ang pinakamaraming tinetest na umabot na halos ng 4,400,000? Tama po ba yan?
Sunod po sa national government, ang Red Cross po ang pinakamataas ang kanya pong testing output, Your Honor, Mr. Chairman.
Bakit ngayon, kung mapayag ang paggamit ngayon dito sa ating presidente?
5 million pesos. That's how much the government could have supposedly saved in just one of the transactions between Farmily and the procurement services of the budget department. That is, if the agency had properly vetted the deal. Documents presented during the Senate hearing showed Farmily sourced some 500,000 pieces of face masks from a middleman, which it sold for a higher price to the government. Senators also found that nearly 400,000 test kits that came from Farmily were wasted as they were already expired before they reached the health department.
Shouldn't you have, as the purchasing procuring entity, di ba, negotiate for a lower price than SRP because you're buying wholesale. You're not buying retail. That gives us the gravity of the waste, the incompetence, the corruption that we are facing. And Senators Secretary also- Duque can respond. Do you think, is this acceptable to you?
No, Mr. Chairman. It's not acceptable to me, Mr. Chairman.
Senators also questioned the budget department why its procurement service charges a 4% markup for supplies it purchases for other government agencies. PSDBM official Joshua Laure confirmed the agency charges a constant markup of 4% for common use supplies as well as a 1% service fee. Sonny Angara described the additional fees to be, quote, a little anomalous.
What is the policy justification for the service fee and the markup? Hindi ba yung purpose nga ng agency is to realize economies of scale and thus cost savings? Mr. Parang nadagdagan pa nga yung gastos, di ba? Yeah, you sec, Tina. Go ahead.
The reason for the 4% is the procurement service is not charging against the General Appropriations Act. So they buy in bulk. So ang rationale is they get it at a much lower price. So even if the agencies will pay the 4%, it is still lower than the market.